The Morrison government will extend the JobSeeker payment until March, although it will cut the rate by $100 a fortnight in the new year. It comes as a Labor MP resigned from the front bench today, declaring his party had lost touch with workers.
Here we go.
Labor hosts a smoking ceremony in Parliament, a symbol of a fire burning in its ranks.
I've been trying to put Labor back into the Labor Party.
Outspoken MP Joel Fitzgibbon has quit Labor's frontbench, saying the move was long planned so he can focus on retaining his now marginal regional seat, but voicing deep concerns.
And we lost touch with traditional working people.
And highlighting his party's climate policies as electoral poison.
If you want to act on climate change, the first step is to become the government.
He made the traditional pledge of loyalty.
I do have confidence in Anthony Albanese.
But Joel Fitzgibbon's departure spotlights Labor's deep internal fractures and exposes his leader to awkward questions.
What you should be doing is holding this government to account now.
But this government knows a gift when it sees it.
Driven out by an ideological group of zealots, Mr. Speaker, on that side of the House, who have no interest in the jobs of Australians and regional areas.
Today, Scott Morrison also faced the charge that he's abandoning those in need of support.
Isn't this the worst possible time for the Prime Minister to cut the coronavirus supplement?
The JobSeeker coronavirus supplement will be extended from January 1 until March 31, but cut from $250 to $150, pushing the total payment down from $815 to $715 a fortnight. The extension will cost $3.2 billion and support 1.5 million Australians.
We need to ensure that those emergency measures move with the recovery that is underway.
Chris Yeoman, Nine News.